This decapasaw blade covers about 25 feet and 10 frames of film, or about a third of a second, which means it's traveling somewhere in the range of 50 miles per hour. Considering it was about 25 feet behind Chekhov's scientists at this point, and still doesn't catch him for another 4 seconds, that means to outrun it for that long, he would have to be running at least... It's hilarious that you think I would actually do the math, but there's no way he's running that f***ing fast miles per hour. Also, they show the blade passing through the same set of trees 4 different times. I've seen it before, and I'll see it again.
Just a little bit of forestry tree beating.
The president, giant spider.
Wasting your breath on exposition while running for your life. I knew the 15-second logo was too good to be true. Movie makes me pay for my unbridled optimism by slapping us in the face with a full 2 minutes of opening credits.
The legendary Captain James West.
I hope this movie just goes full names position and makes every character say the full name and title of every other character in every conversation. In fact, every movie should do this. Colonel Nathan Roy Jessup, did you order the code red? You don't have to answer that question, Colonel Nathan Roy Jessup. I'll answer the question, Judge Julius Alexander Randolph. You want answers, Lieutenant Junior Grade Daniel Alistair Covey? I think I'm entitled to them, Colonel Nathan Roy Jessup. Lieutenant Junior Grade Daniel Alistair Covey, you want answers? Colonel Nathan Roy Jessup, I want the truth. You can't handle the truth, Lieutenant Junior Grade Daniel Alistair Covey. See? Perfect. A bunk, shelves, and this conveniently buoyant table are all ridiculous additions to what appears to be a functioning water tower. But the sin is swimming in this water. I'm nearly certain the pH and chlorine values are way off. I can't decide if the lamer part of this joke is Will Smith pretending he would be making fishy faces to keep up the charade of making out, that she wouldn't notice he's turning his head while she's kissing him for several seconds, or that he wouldn't notice her eventually noticing him faking love to her for a few more seconds after she's stopped kissing him.
Next stop, New Orleans.
Is there a particular reason to verbalize the destination aside from giving convenient clues to the audience and our protagonist? Holy sh**! Did you remember this PG-13 movie pulled a full reverse turtle? There's almost a full second of this package being completely out for delivery. I mean, I'm sure it's not actually the King's Richard, but how did I forget Wild Wild West with full turnscroat?
Sure could use some clothes down here, ma'am.
This is interpreted as throw me a hat, because an insecure naked man was funny in 1999, and it only gets funnier the more prolonged his discomfort is. They both are suddenly scared of his penis, which is super confusing because it's been hanging out for a while now and should no longer have the element of surprise. That's too many dots. Ellipses are like hockey games, movie. They only need 3 periods to get the job done. Hitting on someone by suckling the air. Also, get it? It's hilarious because he's hitting on a man dressed as a woman. Now laugh!
Direct me to the poop, sir. I want something young and creamy.
This movie is gross.
You gotta be interested. You're a whore.
No one likes their job all the time, and I think that is a timeless concept that even this bigoted asshole should understand. There is no possible way that brooch had enough flower power to knock someone out. The only thing that man should have to worry about is the possible trauma of a light sneeze. Is this convenient rope track really much faster than just running? I submit not.
Nitro!
This is not the way you transport nitro!
To be fair, the criminals probably weren't planning on you spooking their horses, so you can't be sure they weren't going to make some final adjustments that would make it suited for a more leisurely transport. So quit being a dick about pointing out mistakes that might not actually be mistakes, you pedantic asshole. Ear jelly. Also, did he just snort snot and it immediately dripped out of his ear pavilion? Movie doesn't know how to use station tube correctly. I believe this shot is attempting to indicate that all of these people stop f***ing to come out and listen to this song. This seems unlikely. Movie thinks that hypnotism is a thing and that it can occur this quickly. It's not like, oh, getting a little sleepy. Guess I'll just lay down and... This guy was running past Jim here, making this clothesline completely unnecessary. It was hilarious and would have gotten a sin removal if it felt like a character choice and not just bad fight choreography.
I'm a U.S. Marshal! Stay out of my way!
Get out of my way. Get out of my way.
Even if there was some sort of convenient sightline to where Smith and Klein are having this conversation away from any obvious windows, and she could somehow see both of their mouths, how did she know to be looking in that exact spot for them? Is she a mutant whose powers are clairvoyance, x-ray vision, and extreme lip reading?
So Miss Lippen Reader informs me.
The lip reader is named Lippen Reader. I suppose at this point I shouldn't be surprised. Letting mindless, useless creatures wander around the White House. Also, these sheep.
Somebody mind telling me what the hell is going on here?
Sure, I can help. So, you called this meeting to tell these guys to work together. Even though you set up this meeting, one of them arrived in full makeup pretending to be you, while the second guy nearly killed the imposter before you walked in late, and after security didn't barge in when they heard a gunshot. Make sense?
One of us was trying to catch McGrath, and the other was trying to marry him.
We don't have time for this.
Movie indeed does actually have time for this.
The letter was delivered today, with that cake. It's marzipan, isn't it? Careful.
Yeah, be careful. It has spiders that are trained in the art of synchronized dramatic revelation.
And I don't need intelligence to tell me that.
No, you'd rather rely on stupidity.
So it's reluctant partners who are forced to work together and will eventually bond and put aside their differences, yada, yada, yada. Why wasn't the title of this movie just dull, dull cliche? How the hell is this penny farthing staying upright while being stationary? I won't send all the ridiculous physics in this movie, but this launch pad sends West straight up into the air, and he somehow goes forward to the precise train car roof opening. I haven't seen licenses taken with gravity and inertia this insane since the breast physics on Street Fighter V had to be packed.
This is not needlepoint.
Yes, because using needles to connect metal rings seems completely absurd, and I don't know why the movie is pretending these are the most effective tools for doing this.
My latest invention. I call it the impermeable.
No, this is chainmail, and its invention is suspected to have occurred sometime in the 3rd or 4th century BC. If yours stops a bullet, then it's definitely the best chainmail, but it's still chainmail. If you're gonna add errant dings, we're gonna add errant synths. Why is this lever even here? Not saying there isn't a valid reason, but this movie has a terrible question-to-answer ratio.
According to the retinal terminus theory, a dying person's last conscious image is burned into the back of his eyeball, rather like a photograph.
And I had all this set up ahead of time on this train, but because of our clear and evident mutual respect, and the fact that I didn't even know we were going to be forced to work together, waited until this very moment to try the last part of it out. Also, some bullshit movie science that has been debunked many times by actual science makes it into the movie.
Huh. Refraction of the lenses causes the image to appear upside down.
And thankfully, I had it installed on a machine made specifically for turning the head upside down, even though I'm pretending like I'm just figuring this part out right now. This nonsense manages to not only provide a clue, but also a clue within the clue that tells them exactly when and where they need to go next. And all this convenient information doesn't somehow wrap this movie up in an efficient 30 minutes.
346 Pine Court Garden District.
Also, that sure was a whole lot of bullshit to go through for what turned out to be a simple zoom and enhance cliche.
That night at Fat Cans, it wasn't a difficult task to see that you weren't a woman.
Basing gender on specific visual standards is probably its own sin, but even so, you yourself gendered him female up until the moment he took off the wig and you reacted like this. So maybe stop trying to sell a story the buyer has to prove is false.
These breasts are a work of art, aesthetically and scientifically perfect.
Using science to justify personal taste.
Just one. Touch one.
You happy, Gordon? I'm touching your breasts.
I knew it.
He thinks they're gay. That's why we're supposed to laugh. The possibility of homosexuality. That's the whole joke. Now laugh!
Buckwheat. That's your problem.
Sure, we could sin the inherent sexism involved here, but the really offensive part of this is that Gordon would create a watertight bladder for these breast inserts, even though he had somehow never thought about using liquid to simulate a breast. The straps on his boob vest are the same fabric as the outside of this coat, meaning either he prepped the boobs for this specific moment, or he always wears the boobs on the outside of this coat. Again, more questions than answers.
I was just going to jot down a note.
You know, Gordon, I think you underestimate the convenience of a pocket.
I was gonna say that! Jim West would be excellent at stealing my cinema sins. This spiderweb door pattern reminds me of the window in Doctor Strange, and this sliding introduction into the room reminds me of the Blofeld scene in No Time to Die. This is despite the fact that neither of those comparisons is really even that close. That's right, this movie is so annoying my brain is desperately trying to shout out other barely related movies it would rather be watching. Under Siege!
It's me, dear friends.
I can't decide if this batshit Kenneth Branagh performance is the best thing about the movie or the worst. My head says, sin it. But my heart says, remove a sin for it. Like I have a heart.
Do we ever lose our sense of humor?
Me giving myself a pep talk after reading the YouTube comments somehow makes its way into the script.
Mr. Wells.
Protagonist and antagonist meet 30 minutes into the movie, and it doesn't end right here. Hypothetically, if one of them were to shoot the other, we wouldn't have to suffer through the rest of this film. That doesn't happen, so the movie gets a bunch of sins for not showing us any mercy.
Well, perhaps the lovely Miss East will keep you from being a slave to your disappointment.
Well, you know beautiful women, they encourage you 1 minute and cut the legs out from under you the next.
Mr. Lovelace responds to Mr. West's extremely ableist comment with an extremely racist comment, which Mr. West follows with another ableist comment that is also extremely sexist. Well, yippee-yay, f***ing haul, we got ourselves an Istar. Villain leaves because his feelings are hurt, instead of just killing James West right then and there. And I don't want to hear about how some villains enjoy toying with their opponent more than actually winning. That's only fun to watch when the villain's motives are interesting. Lovelace just wants to build insane-looking super weapons, conquer the United States, and then retire to the Northwest.